Dear students, in today's module, we will discuss the concept of data structure. So, the conceptual shape or arrangement of data is known as data structure. For example, if you want to store the name of a person, so for example, the name of a person is Ali Haider. So, that Ali Haider is basically a sequence of characters. So remember, in the previous module, we defined a character variable. So in this case, different character variables should be joined together to form a name of that person, and that can be done using a predefined data structure, which we will be showing in you the next slide. And then, for example, there is you want to store the marks of 5 students. So you have one data type of, for example, float. So, but one data type float will not be sufficient enough to store marks of 5 subjects of a student. So we need organization or conceptual shape in such a scenario to store the data. So, in both of these examples, we need to store or we need to use an array. So, for example, if we want to store the marks of a student for 5 subjects, so we will have or we should have such 5 possibilities, which are 5 float variables joined together. And here you can say the marks of English are stored, so 50.5. The marks of ITP are stored, 80. The marks of some other subjects are stored, some other subjects are stored, and some other subjects are stored. So this joined together collective data, which has been joined in a proper shape to comprehend this particular problem, is known as array data structure. And this array data structure can be defined like float, which we did in the previous module, and you say the name, the variable name, and then you say in bracket as 5. So, in the braces, you have written 5. So, this 5 means that we need 5 consecutive memory locations in the RAM of type float. And these will be given to us in the shape of an array. So, this statement is known as, we are defining a float type array of 5 elements. So similarly, if you want to store the name like Ali Haider, so this means we need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So we need 10 joint locations of type character. So you will say character name of 10. So these 10 locations will be given to us in the RAM. Those would be continuous or contiguous memory locations, collective memory locations, accumulative memory locations. They reside collectively in the RAM, and they are total 10, as our requirement was to store the name of Ali Haider. And the name of this collective memory location will be accessed using name, and the type is character. Then there is another data structure known as record. So the previous data structure array was storing the information of similar type. So when we defined a float, so this means all of these values would be float. So you cannot store one float and then one character. So you cannot store A here. You need to store the numeric values or the float values over here. Similarly, when you define the character, then you cannot store any numeric or float value. You need to store all of the characters in all of the 10 memory locations. So in the record structure, data structure, that can contain different types of data. So for example, we want to store the information of an employee. That might have a name, that might have a age, and that has a skill. So the name is of character type, and the age is of integer type, and then the skill rating is of float type. So we will define it like this in a programming language. So we will say struct, we need a character whose name is, whose name would be the name. So the memory location, the 25 consecutive memory location of type character will be called name, and then its age in integer, its skill rating in float, and the name, overall name of all of this structure will be called as employee. And then there are many, many other data structures also available in reality. For example, lists, for example, tree, graph, and many, many other subtypes of those data structures. And some of those data structures we will be studying in next modules. So if we conclude today's module, we have learned about different data structures like arrays, records, and some other data structures as well.